shown that as at today, 50% of marriages end in divorce. Yet, the number keeps increasing. Before now, I mean in the last 5 years, hardly will you see any couple, yeah, splitting up, like maybe after 15 or 20 years of marriage, because by then, of course, their children are even grown. You expect, or normally they stick together. Whatever it is they are going through, they just overlook it and just stick together. But unfortunately, it is this. Even 30-year-old marriage crashes. You will just say, okay, 30 years and they are no more together, like seriously. At a stage where their first child is most likely married, or even already thinking of getting married. Okay, and that means that any couple at any time, no matter how old they are in marriage, they can still divorce or separate. Okay, so ways of preventing this problem has been a major concern for most people. It is for this reason that we have decided to discuss the topic, why are marriages failing, tonight on Ladies Unscripted. From the stereo of Rave 91.7 FM, my name is Wanda
Ajibobola.
Good evening.
Humbly.
Yes. Your host on Ladies Unscripted. And of course, you know I do not walk alone. Yes. I'm in the house tonight with my radio diva, Sharon Olofi Tuyi. In case you do not know, or in case you're joining us for the very first time, Ladies Unscripted is a talk show where we ladies talk about issues that are related mainly to women, to relationship, to marriage, you know. We talk about it, we come out here, we discuss those problems, those issues that women generally are having, whether they're married or they are married. And people call in, they tell us what they feel, their opinion. That is after our expert in the house has given us the expert opinion. And that is why we have Sharon Olofin Tuyi in the house. Sharon Olofin Tuyi is a relationship expert. Good evening, Sharon.
Hi, good evening, Wanda.
You can see I'm sounding really serious, and
I'm surprised. I was like, come, what's the spirit that has just landed on you?
Oh, wait for it.
The spirit of humility.
Yes.
Humble you.
Yes, thank
Hallelujah.
You. Hallelujah. Okay. Okay, so I was saying, you know, this issue of divorce, separation, you know, you attend a wedding this year, and before 6 months, a year, they tell you, oh, we're no more together. You know, every day lawyers are filing more divorce cases in court, and you just wonder what's happening. People spend so much on planning the marriage. So much so that they totally forgot. Oh, they plan so much planning the wedding. You know, they spent so much planning the wedding that they totally forget about the marriage. Sharon,
yes.
You know, I know for a fact that one very important reason why marriages these days, why marriages are crashing like just anyhow these days, is finances.
Yeah.
Yes, but I also know that there are other reasons. Now, as the expert in this field, Sharon, I want you to tell us, what are these reasons? Why are marriages not lasting like they used to? What is happening?
Well, there is no one single reason why marriages are crashing today.
Okay.
There is no single reason. Usually, it's a combination of issues coming together. Like you likely said, finance.
Yes,
but that is not actually the reason for the separation or for the divorce. No, there might have been something somewhere within the home.
Okay.
That is that added to that. I've seen families who got married and things are not actually working smoothly for them. The man immediately got married, the man was out of job and all that. But when there is love, when there is unity, when other factors are in place, that marriage can still survive.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not basically on one particular reason.
Or the
it may
other.
Be due to unforgiveness.
Wow.
You know, when you carry too much unforgiveness in your heart, from the day one you got married, and then at a particular point, the issue of your financial issue now added to it.
Okay. Sorry to cut you short. You talked about unforgiveness. You're moving to something else already, but I want you to talk about, because I have seen situations where after 10, 20 years of marriage, couple will have issues, you know, and when they're on the verge of separating, and you get to talk to one of the parties, maybe the husband, and it would tell you stuff that happened 10 years ago, 5 years ago. You know, it might not even tell you anything that happened yesterday,
just now,
or 2 years, or two days ago. It will be telling you things that happened 5 years ago, and you will be like, okay, you want to divorce your wife because of something she did 5 years ago.
It happens. You know, someone who has gone through a lot of trauma, either emotional trauma or there is a particular pain that she has been through, all on the to make a sacrifice for the home.
Yes.
And this man is not doing anything to heal the wound.
Okay.
When the wound is still as fresh as ever, you should expect such.
Okay.
This is a man who, okay, let's take a recent, for instance, a man who is a serial cheater, who cheats so much, and this man just refused to change. I have seen a situation, or we've had situations whereby the wife had to abort for the housemaid.
Oh.
Not one, not two, not three of them. All in the effort to keep the home and to make the home stand.
Okay.
And in a situation where this man continues repeating the same thing, my dear, you're not healing up that wound.
Okay. So, but where is the space? The place of communication. You know, if even as friends, we are not married. Even as friends, you know, somebody has done something wrong. It is okay for you two to just talk about it, you know, and let it just end there. Why should you carry a grudge of over 5 years? You know,
like I've rightly said, keeping the grudge of over 5 years, it's very, very possible.
Okay.
If you promise me, if we have a kind of a dialogue, or we are going to communicate on a particular issues, and you continually repeating the same thing.
Okay.
So where is that? Okay, I can talk to you, and then you feel so remorseful, and then you promise me a change, and I'm not getting that change. What exactly do you expect such a woman to do? Such a woman is going through bitterness. So there's every possibility that you have to refer back. You know, it is surprising when you see a lady, the wife saying,
okay.
That's how you did the other time. That was because there was a repetition of the event again.
Okay.
A reoccurrence of such events.
All right.
One thing is to have a communication, another thing to have effective communication.
Okay. Isn't that another reason why marriages are failing?
Of course. See, when it comes to communication,
yes,
you must be ready for a change.
Okay.
I am bringing this matter to the table because I really want a change. I want a stop to this.
Okay.
Do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
So, and when it comes to, how would I put it? Your expectations not being met in marriage. And do you know that you have stretching limits?
Okay.
When you stretch a woman or a man beyond that limit, my dear, such marriages are bound to be broken.
Okay. However, personally, I believe that is the reason why we had courtship before we got married, you know. When you two during those years, you know, you're supposed to learn about each other's character. You know my limits, I know your limits.
Well,
you know,
it's unfortunate, so, people marry for physical attractions. I am seeing that figure eight, just like Wanda is looking right now. You know, that's figure eight, that nice shape, that look, you know, that complexions and all that. And unfortunately, 3 years, 4 years down the line, this woman is looking, that figure eight is now figure 28. So when you have that, you know, you're like, this is not the same woman I am married to 4 years ago. This may be due to so many factors. Maybe a hormonal change, the hormonal changes in the body. Sometimes a woman strives so hard just to maintain the shape, but it depends on your ability or your person. And then when that figure turns to figure 28, you see me and looking at that question. Is this the same woman?
Hello, it is not like men do not change. So why should anybody be particular about if you think your wife is going out of shape? There's what you can do about it. You encourage her. You tell her, okay, why not do this? Why not? Let's jog together.
I actually canceled someone of recent.
Okay.
It was actually the man that actually came to me and he said, "This is my tummy. My wife has been complaining.
You see,
what do I do to my tummy?" And you know, when I spoke with the lady, she said, "My husband is not even looking attractive any longer."
Mm.
If you don't do anything, behold, you mean that marriage will lead to something else? I'm like, come, just appreciate the good. After all, you are the one doing all the cooking now. As I said, you fed this man, he's fed up, and then the whole boss said, "No life." And
wow,
and well, we made the joke out of that.
Mm.
So if you continue to nurse such a feeling within you, it's not fine again, it's not this again, so just appreciate this man. And another factor is you looking at other people's lives or other people's marriage from afar.
Mm. And you're not using that as some kind of guideline for your own marriage.
Forgetting that there is always a reason why the grass in your neighbor's compound or your neighbor's yard is greener.
Wow.
There is a reason. It is either it is artificial or you are not tending your own. If you are tending yours and that one is not, just do something. Don't look at, okay, let me say for instance, I had a talk with one of my friends in church today, and then she was making an instance of a friend who I actually know very well, of the challenges she's going through then. And she said, "Sharon, do you know I almost killed myself?" Wow. I said, "Why?" She said, "Each time this friend comes to me, she'll tell me how far they have gone in their building, their own personal house, how far they have gone, and all that. And then she was like, "Hey, which kind of husband did I marry now? Even come on, quarter plot of land. This man does not have." You know, she said she almost killed herself just for everything to open up and to realize that this man does not even have, is that 1/8 of land somewhere?
Mm.
He does not even have anything.
Wow. Okay. Please come again.
She was there. She was killing herself because of what her friend told her. Actually, the friend doesn't know because the man has always been telling her all the sweet words. They are married, for goodness sake.
Wow.
This man has nothing. Nothing. You see the problem we're having?
Yes.
Now she has this imagination and this feelings that our friends' grass is so green. So green and beautiful.
Unknown to her, the grass is actually artificial.
The grass is not even there. The grass is not even there. So these are some of the complicated issues that happens. Now she has been facing her husband like, what kind of husband are you and all that. If she didn't apply wisdom to that, just imagine what will have happened to her marriage today.
Wow.
All because you're just seeing that green light somewhere and you feel that your husband isn't doing anything. Just appreciate what you've got.
Okay.
Appreciate your man.
Okay.
You know, one of the major factor is not appreciating one another.
Mm.
You see a man who has gone so far doing everything to put the home in place to make you happy in his own capacity, some even outside the capacity, making sure that you're fine, make sure that the home is running fine, and at the end of the day all you got from your wife is you have not done anything.
Mm.
So how do you expect such home to stand? Such home can't stand. There will always be problems. Wanda.
Yes.
Just imagine yourself, you go to office every day, returning back at the office, you there have to take care of the children. After taking care of the children, you have to go to take care of your husband, making sure that, and at the end of the day, your husband just walked to you and said,
"So what have you been doing?
What have you been doing?"
Wow.
what is so special about no, it can be so painful and so degrading. So when you have such those no factors, so many factors coming together ruins a home.
Okay. There's another thing. You know, there's this thing people say, okay, men say about women that we nag. How true is that? Do we really nag, or men simply just they're just not understanding our nature? Well, you know, because I know that this is something else, another factor, you know.
When a woman is unhappy, you will nag.
When a woman is unhappy,
you will nag. But if a man does everything to make your life comfortable, not money now, well, money plays a major role anyway. If a man does everything to give you comfort, my dear, there's no reason for you to nag. I was listening to a program on radio, on television, right, sometimes last week.
Okay.
And it was actually on pregnancy issues. And the woman was asked, why is it that the way you behave when you have your first pregnancy is different from the way you behave when you have your second pregnancy?
Second one.
And she was like, come, it's not all about you behaving anyhow. Fine, the hormonal changes are always there. But when you are given the necessary things of life, or maybe when you have your first pregnancy, things weren't so smooth.
Okay.
But by the time you're having the second pregnancy, you have everything in place. Definitely such pregnancy may be kind of much more easier than the first. Same thing goes in marriage. When a woman is unhappy, definitely you will nag. Now, it is not left for the man to find out the reason. Why is this woman nagging?
Okay. Why is this woman nagging?
Why?
Because some men, they don't even care. They if you like, hit your head on the rock, you're on your own.
You know, they said a woman, I don't know if Kitty can help me with that. A woman avidly speaks 8,000 words in a day.
Really?
About, yes, 8,000 words in a day. And some man was like, when you see your wife shouting and nagging, please allow her, she needs to meet up.
I'm hearing that for the very first
time. And some men were like, okay, leave her, let her shout. She needs to shout. So you need to find out the reason
why
your wife is nagging. You know, I'm a kind of person that when my husband offends me, unknowingly to me, not really because I really want to show it, you know, nagging sometimes is the reflex action.
Oh.
It's not something that you just do willingly. You
like,
just
okay, I'm going to nag today.
You know, you just don't know when
the pressure everything is just too much.
You just nag, you become so touchy and all that. So when I begin to exhibit such, yeah, she'll see.
I'll be hopeful as well.
You know, is there? Take it there. Then you should be able to ask questions. Then if will I use the word, a man, a responsible man or reasonable man, will have a flashback.
Okay, and just try and see, okay, what have I done wrong?
What
this
exactly
time?
Have I done wrong? You know, just try and look back, maybe from daybreak, maybe it happens in the evening and all that, and then just check yourself. Then you can be able to trace, is it because of what I said in the car
while we're on the way from the office? Right.
Or you can always trace that back. And when you do that, you have like, wow, so this man
is actually mindful of me.
Yeah, you know, there is this kind of way you feel as a woman. I know I have a man who understands my feelings. No, it's a good feeling though. It's a very good feeling.
Okay. Very soon we'll be going on a very short break, but before then I would like to give us one more point before we go on our short break.
Another factor is your what family pressure.
Okay.
When family pressures is just too much on a man. When a man has to...
Oh, you mean like so much responsibility?
So much responsibility. And not only that, you know, I've seen people going through some problems going on in the home. And then, I mean the extended home.
Oh, okay.
And this man had to take care of his own family,
immediate family, then take care of the extended family.
And here you have your wife who is also bringing problems from our issues from our own family, mounting everything on the man. This man will break up one day. Likewise to the woman, you're doing everything to make the home stand, and then your mother-in-law is on your neck, placing so much pressure.
Yes, I think we once talked about that.
Yes,
you know, allowing the third party to influence your decisions.
Placing so much. One of my friends said each time she just hear that mother-in-law is coming, my whole sister will just turn upside down. Hey, I'm in trouble.
Wow.
It shouldn't be. A man should be able to put his mother where she, not where she belong as a mother. No man wants to have two mother at the same time.
Of course, I can imagine that.
Your wife is almost standing in place, and your mother is also, it's somehow, sometimes your mother-in-law want to make themselves their son's wife again. So that is not going to work.
Yeah. Can you remember a particular caller who called us when we treated this issue of mother-in-law? She called somewhere, I think from GRA. Talked about how our mother-in-law will bring breakfast, will bring lunch, and then they will go to our mother-in-law's house to eat dinner.
I remember.
And that was why and how the marriage ended.
So now tell me, what is the work of that woman? You are actually taking our office away from her, and no woman wants to go through such. So definitely that woman is going to break. When you have a man who whatever the mother says is the final say. How do you expect such a woman to cope? Every woman wants to be in charge. Every woman wants to take charge of her office. When that office is being taken away, my dear, forget it. That home is not going to stand, no matter what you do.
Okay. Thank you very much, Sharon Olofintuyi. I know you still have one or two things to talk to us about. But before then, we'll go on a very short break. When we come back, the phone lines will be opened for our callers to call us and, you know, tell us why marriages are failing. Okay, so we'll be going on a very short break. Please stay with us.
I learned Hello, my name is Belinda Akinyakiyonde. Keep listening to Rave 91.7 FM. Don't touch that dial.
All right, you're still on to Rave 91.7 FM, and the program you're listening to right now is Ladies Unscripted with my humble self, Wonder Ajibobola. And of course, I have with me in the house tonight my very own relationship expert, Sharon Olofintuyi. Hello, Sharon. Okay, so Sharon has been talking about, we have been talking about reasons why marriages are failing, you know, why people can't stand each other anymore. 1 year, 2 years, that's just the end. So why are these things happening? Why are marriages failing? Sharon has talked about reasons why, as a marriage expert, she has talked about a couple of reasons why marriages are failing. She talked about forgiveness, she talked about effective communication, she talked about using someone else's relationship or marriage as a yardstick for your own. She talked about influence, you know, from a third party. She talked about pressure. Okay, right about now we shall be opening the phone lines, but before we do that, Sharon, you want to talk about something?
It will be complete if I don't talk about this.
Okay, please.
Although
go on.
We try to hide it behind and then just overlook it like it doesn't really matter, but it matters, and that is sexual intercourse.
Okay,
when you have problems in that area,
even Gidi is laughing
because
Gidi knows it is a very important
aspect.
Why
you don't know how to explore every areas? We call it bedmatics. If you don't go for that course and know how to satisfy your woman or your man, you know that particular point to reach. Hey, there is problem.
Wow,
many people are leaving marriages because of that. And please make sure you guide your home jealously, whatever way you can please your man. I've had some couples saying that permit me to say it's oral sex or something, it's or whatever other way of enjoying your man is a sin, or is a sin against God and against your body, and God is actually against it. My dear, don't listen to them. What they are doing inside that the other room it's something. So please learn how to satisfy your man. I have seen a man with four children who left you. This man wasn't fornicating. He's a faithful man, but unfortunately for him, he went to a club with a friend, and that friend said, look at that woman, she's very nice, she's a single mother, you can just try it just once now, just shake with Bojukumbe. And this man just went to it, and the man was like, come, if I have to die here, I will die here.
Are you serious? This is what I've been missing.
He left the wife with four children. Could you believe that? He was doing everything in place for them.
Yeah.
But he moved out of the house. When he was summoned, the woman was going up and down. She wasn't saying the right thing. And the man stood up and said, sir, this woman, just one night, I enjoyed her.
Wow.
And I can't leave her alone.
Wow.
So please,
that
area should never be ignored. Even a nagging woman, if you satisfy a nagging woman, she will stay. Even when there is no money, if that area is intact, at least you are 50% sure that home is going to stand. So please, let's not ignore that area.
Okay, thank you very much, Sharon. Okay, so right about now the phone lines are opened. Okay, so we'll be calling out the phone numbers so that you can call us and tell us why you think marriages are failing. 0703-175-9177, 0902-427-3808. You can also call us on 0905-648-7177. 7777. Okay, and also you can send in your messages on WhatsApp via 0703-175-9173. You can also reach us on our social media platform at Rave917. Please keep your comments short. Yes, so that we'll be able to accommodate other callers. Thank you. Hello, good evening.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
My name is Temini Kolola. I'm calling you.
I know now. I just didn't want to say it before you. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
Very well. Thank you. Thank you for
really,
calling.
Really, really did well. My best part is just to did well.
Amen. Thank you.
And actually, you also brought this very, very important
Yes.
You have spoken well.
Thank
spoken
you.
Well. You've spoken well. In fact, let me tell you something. I think the main part of my own. Number one.
Temi, please try and call us back. Thank you very much. Hello.
Hello.
Good evening.
Name Tim Wonder.
Good evening to you too.
And the Charles, I agree to you. Good evening, ma.
Good evening.
You give God justice to the topic tonight.
Thank you.
Yeah. Mr. Gidi, I agree to you.
He's greeting you too.
The other part is on the way.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
How is the whole of estate tonight?
Thank you.
Okay.
I've said virtually everything that needs to be said. But I just want to say something.
Okay, please.
I have a friend.
Yes.
Who had something similar to one of the things she mentioned.
Okay.
The husband's mom is always coming to the house. In fact, it's like a tradition. Every weekend, she'll be the one to do the cooking and all that.
Mm-hmm.
And she is this type of person that she must say that 1,000 words in a day. I think it is the case too much, and the guy could not behave. But the mommy's boy is. I don't know what happened. One day she went to work. He went to work too. But on coming back, the guy had moved every damn thing he bought from the house, leaving only her stuff in the house.
Wow, that's serious. Wow.
He went to get the marriage certificate, took it out, and left with it. I'm gonna blame both the male and the female in this aspect.
Okay.
For the ladies, a lot of them go about looking at their friends. Oh, my friend is this, is that. My home must also be like this.
Okay.
And that is one of the reasons that was so much broken homes today.
Mm-hmm.
And for the guys, if you know that this thing is beyond your power, why you guys are coming? My brother, don't do it. Tell how you can. But by the time you go an extra mile to please a woman, then when you guys finally come in and settle, and you now start relenting and saying, "Oh, Abraham, you can."
Okay.
Definitely, there will be problems.
Mm. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Martins. Thank you. Hello.
Hello.
Temi.
This is Temi. I called back.
Okay. Thank you for calling back.
I want to go check on what sounds did last minute.
Okay.
You know, when I was this single, two men came in my way. They didn't hide the fact that they married. But when I asked them that they said that you married, why did you want to have an extra marital outside the marriage? They said, let me be frank with you. Just that my wife married me of sex. Did you know that? And I told them, I'm so sorry, I could not be your sex mate. Yes, ma'am. There are a lot of women out there. They did not willingly get married to the person they married to. Yes, some they married due to the pressure from their parents. Some get married because of my mates were getting married. Let me also be referred to as Mrs.
Somebody.
But the main reason, the main factor why someone should be married is not having, even they do not have the knowledge of what marriage is all about. And it is very painful hearing it here and there, separation, divorce. Please, Auntie Sharon.
Yes,
yeah. God will help you. Please,
amen.
Focus on what we can do to prevent this from our community.
Amen. It is well. Thank you very much, Timmy. Hello.
Hello, this is the other Martin.
Okay.
Please, I have a question.
Yes, go ahead.
During the men's, one of the men's programs on Friday,
yes,
he said a topic, and it has to do with what we are discussing tonight.
Oh, okay.
You said in one of your points, dogmatics is one of the vital points for the women must be proven.
Yes.
Are you now saying for the men, they shouldn't wait till the wedding night before they do that thing?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
No.
That one is a topic for another day. Thank you very much, Martin. Hello.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Lucky from Ileife.
Okay, Lucky from Ileife. Thank you for calling.
Yes, ma.
Okay. Go on.
I think the issue is that the reason why did not last or did not is contented.
Contentment.
Yeah, contentment.
Okay.
They are not with what they have.
Okay. Oh, thank you very much, Lucky. Okay, so let's quickly take some messages on WhatsApp. This one is from Ola Bisola from Kobo. Well done. Marriage fail because people are not waiting for God's time. Okay. Hello.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
I'd like to make a contribution.
Okay. Your name and where you're calling us from?
My name is Toyeshi. I'm calling from Oshogbo.
Toyeshi from Oshogbo. Please go on.
Yeah. There's something you seem to have missed out.
Which is?
And I think it's the issue of compatibility.
Okay.
I don't know if you've talked about it on this program before.
Yes.
Yes.
But I think, okay, I think a man and a woman, they should get to know each other very well before, you know, delving into the, I mean, into matrimony. And there's something I know. It's not scriptural, though. Some people may not like it. Some people may not apply it. But I mean, there's nothing wrong in going psychic when you want to get married.
In going what?
There's nothing wrong in going psychic, checking yourselves up.
That's what I mean. Oh, okay,
There are four cardinal. That is, I mean, four cardinal elements: the element of fire, the element of water, the element of air, and the element of earth. You know, if a man who belongs to the element of water takes on a wife who is element of fire, I mean, how do you expect them to walk?
Okay.
The woman will always be, you know, the go-getter, while the man is always, you know, cool. It's really going to complement whatever she does.
Okay.
I think it's very important that, you know, you get to know if you're compatible. A man who is an element of water should get married to a woman who is from the element of earth. Mm. A man who is element of fire should get a woman who is element of earth. That's the only way things like that can work out. It's not scriptural, but I've seen people who applied it and it really worked in their marriage.
Okay, thank you very much, Lucky. Thank you for calling. Hello, good evening.
Good evening, Wanda.
Good evening to you, too.
I really appreciate what you're treating tonight.
Okay, thank you. Your name?
And, my name is Angela Ladi from Capital.
Okay, please go.
In Oshibuya.
Okay.
I think it's practical because I've actually practiced it.
Okay.
Usually everybody in marriage has actually had one challenge or the other.
Yes.
But the truth about it is that if you communicate well, honestly, all these problems can be solved.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's even genetical or ethical, or even if it's even due to economic situation, if you talk about it, it will always be handled. If you imagine a lot that, okay, fine, he should see it this way, she should see it this way, you realize at the end of the day that you are just guessing. And the other person might not even be looking at it from the angle that you are looking at it, but the moment you talk about it, then attention is going to be called to it, or his attention is going to be called to it, and you realize that a little effort you just applied, then a great result will yield.
Wow. Okay.
I just want to say thank you to you, because you've been doing a very wonderful work in a lot of families' lives.
Thank you.
I have friends that talked about it. Do you listen to this program? I told them I do. Like tonight now, I've been listening to the program with my wife, and we dedicate a lot about it.
Thank you.
It's a thing we share, even in church, because when we share, you use it to talk to people. Mm-hmm. When you guys have a challenge, share it. Talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
The best thing is the two of you, not even the third party.
Yes.
Because the third party is going to be sentimental one way or the other. It's going to be biased. It's either it favors you or it favors the other person. So when you two sit together, you talk about it. And Wanda actually addressed one area that I love so much.
Okay.
In every area that a man and a woman is actually living their life, don't be too spiritual. If you are too spiritual, you're going to get a lot of things wrong.
Sure.
A lot of things are going to be wrong. Just as you tell people not to be so spiritual, it's also as like telling them not to be too traditional.
Mm.
Because if you want to stick by traditions, a lot of things are wrong. Wow. We are in the death age now.
Yes.
Being energetic does not mean that you have to like be too carnal. No. But know your woman, know what makes her happy, and do what makes her happy.
Mm-hmm.
In doing that, you solve a lot of issues.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you and good night.
Thank you very much for calling. Thank you. Hello.
Hello?
Yes, hello.
Well done, sir. Well done, ma.
Well done, sir. Thank you, sir.
May God reward you for great work you are doing over there.
Amen.
Mr. Agbala James, J.K. Faaji from Okeetia.
Oh, Pa James. Okay. Thank you for calling.
Thank you.
Yes.
If you see why some marriage is collapsed, is Mrs. Asandi.
Okay.
Nowadays, we use, we take marriage like play. We don't know that after marriage, something did here. So we now know that everything is on a sand of God. Instead to pray to God before you enter it, that God, I am going to the second earth. But they will not know that everything is okay. If they see small challenges, they will think that maybe their husband or their wife is not okay. That's why some marriage is collapsed.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Pa James. Okay, Sharon, this one is for you from Faith from Ikirun. Good evening. I am Faith by name from Ikirun. I think one of the things that leads to divorce is lack of trust. Sharon, kudos to you, dear.
Thank you
very much, Faith.
And on Facebook, Ajayi Peter says, I think marriages are failing because of many reasons like doubt, jealousy, maturity, and others. But one thing that I consider to be the leading factor is the boring moments of marriage. And that is from Ajayi Peter. Okay. Adegun Abiodun says, because of lack of trust. Ajayi Fab, the Samad says, no vision. Banker says, I think some marriages fail when there's no mutual understanding between the husband and wife. Well done, ladies. Visaya says, immaturity.
Okay, thank you very much, Giddy. Okay, Sharon, you wanted to say something?
Could you please take the first sentence from that? There's something I want to pick from
the one that said the boring moment.
Yes,
says I think marriages are failing because of many reasons like doubt,
immaturity. Okay, yeah, that's the point I want to pick from that.
Okay,
you know, when you use the word immaturity, you can't just say that the both of them are not growing. I think there's always a problem when only one of them
is growing.
You know, one is growing to acquire more knowledge and doing everything to understand the marriage, to develop itself, and to make the marriage stand. And the other one is just like, you know, this kind of carefree life, you don't care, and you just still run the same way you run the home last year. It's the same way you still want to continue to run it even after kids come in. You know, when you're just both of you, just you and your man, you know, you can do anything, you can eat out. And remember when I didn't have any child then, I can decide, and if we are not cooking, I don't even have strength to cook. And then we'll go to eatery, we just eat, and we're just good to go. But when kids begin to come in, you know, there's always a need for restructuring. And it's not left for either of them or the two of them to grow up
together
to that level.
Yes.
But when only one person is growing, taking up the responsibility, definitely there's going to be a problem.
Okay, so in short, both the man and the woman, they have to be flexible.
They just have to.
Okay.
And
okay, so let me quickly, sorry, Sharon, let me quickly take this one from GD. Okay, good evening, my sisters in the building. Marriage fail due to the fact that the ladies tend to go with guys who are richer without necessarily knowing the guy deeply. Having it in mind, she would adapt to all behavior the guy showcased in the course of marriage. Jide from Oshogbo. Okay, thank you very much, Jide. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, good evening.
Good evening. From Oshogbo.
Victor.
Yes, from Oshogbo.
Okay, thank you for calling. Please go on.
Yes. The topic you raised this evening is very, very interesting.
Thank you.
And there are so many reasons why marriages fail nowadays.
Okay.
When people marry for wrong reasons, it's bound to collapse. Yes. When you marry for wrong reasons, that marriage won't last. You know, when you love someone and you get married to that person, and that person loves you in return, there is nothing the two of you cannot cope with. You have lapses, you have differences, but you cope with them because there is love.
Okay.
You also think about money. Well, nowadays, what do we see? We see wives looking for money here and there. The husband are always out looking for money as well. And little argument at home, nobody wants to say sorry. Everybody wants to tie to his or her own stand. Little issues that will have been solved by mayor saying sorry by the wife or the husband. Nobody wants to do that. Everybody wants to be on his or her point. And, you know, but when you are patient, you know the weakness of your wife, or she knows your weakness, then it is very easy for you to cope with one another.
Okay.
But nowadays, no way. Everybody wants to say, yes, I am correct. Mm-hmm. And that's the reason why you see people, you know, they can't just stand themselves after a couple of months after wedding. You know, and people don't just realize this. And they say, well, then at the point of this feminist.
Yes.
A lot of things people don't even understand. There are so many feminists who understand what feminism is.
Yes.
But most of them don't understand. They just believe that you cannot say yes to your husband all the time. It is not like that. Feminism is just a matter of saying oneness, which is quite different from saying, okay, you have to say yes to me all the time. We are not equal. God knows, we know that. A man and a woman, they are not equal.
Okay, that will be a topic for another day.
Yes, that's a topic for another day,
yes.
For this life, there are so many things that are causing community collapse, and one of them that I have said is that people getting married for the wrong reasons.
Thank you very much, Victor. The long and short of...
to actually say this. Incompatibility in conflict resolution, we should be able to get that right.
Okay.
What I'm actually saying in essence is this. There is a way I can see an issue, maybe when we're having a problem in the house. There is a way I feel it is right for us to solve this.
Yes.
But we have seen men who go as far as reporting the wives to either their pastors or the elders in their church or somewhere, or the parents and all that. So and you have a lady who is ready to bring the matter to the table. When you don't understand yourselves in conflict resolution
it
becomes a problem.
Okay, let's quickly take this last one on WhatsApp. For the single ones like me, I think proper courtship is the key to a good marriage. Put yourself through all manner of tests, okay, and get to know each other better. And for the married ones, understanding is the master key to a wonderful marriage. Bjorn Martins. Thank you, Bjorn.
Okay. Let me not forget to say this.
Yes.
Your love language matters.
Very important.
the same way I'll express my love for you may be different from the way you express love.
Mm.
Some men don't know how to give gifts, but they are fantastic, responsible men.
Wow.
In fact, they are good father and a good husband. Mm. They are husband that when you look, say, ah, God, I wish I can have a man like this.
Wow.
But your own man may not be doing the same thing. Some people are good in buying gifts, you know, giving you 20, as much as calling you 20 times in a day while you're at the office. They are good at coming over to sending you your lunch or even bringing the lunch themselves.
Hmm.
They are very good at that. I went to a friend's house, she might be listening right now, and I looked at the way the man was doing. This man mopped the floor, you know, he cleared up the kitchen. I was actually helping out to make some vegetables in the kitchen.
Wow.
The man came in, hey, are you done with this? Can I clear this? Can I take this away? Can I clean this? And I was like, wow, just look at this man. You know, he was putting everything in place. These are things my husband would not do.
Hmm. But that doesn't make him a less.
Yes.
I'm sorry to cut you short. I have a boss like that.
Mm.
His house is not very far from my house.
Mm.
I love going to his house on a Saturday morning because I know my boss would either be cooking a four or if there's no F, then maybe there will be bread and tea, and the wife will just sit down and relax. All of us, or even me, I will just sit down. We'll just be asking, where is my own?
One day I was like,
I like the way you do your thing and all that. He said, well, I go out Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Also,
so he feels Saturday is only day he asks for the family.
For my wife and my kid,
so,
you know?
That's one of the facts. Just understand the way your man can express love. If you understand that, there will not be a problem.
Okay.
And if your husband is, or your either of them is able to adapt to understand your love language better, good. And if that is the only way he can express love in his own way, why not just embrace and appreciate him for that?
Okay.
And also for the ladies, just the man can also as much as he can to just appreciate that love, and you're good to go. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Sharon, on Loving to Ye. In-house relationship experts, you have done wonderfully well tonight. You've done justice to the topic. Thank you very much. Okay, so it's been a wonderful evening tonight on the stereo, from the stereo of Rave 91.7 FM, and we have talked about reasons why marriages are crashing. Calls are still coming in, but sorry, time is no more on our side. Maybe you should just paint that call till next week. We really, really do appreciate you. Thank you for always being part of this amazing program. And to our very own producer, Gidi the Best Man, thank you very much for always being there for us. To our executive producer, Mr. Femi Adefila, thank you very much. Once again, to our listener, we appreciate you. And on tonight's program, this is where we'll be drawing the curtain. Until next week, when we shall be here again to give you another exciting topic, stay tuned and have a wonderful evening. Good night.